In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a volume emitter animation in 7 minutes. Let's create a UV sphere. Right-click to shade smooth. Shift D to duplicate, and Z to bring it down a bit. S to scale. Let's create a volume emitter. This is hair, and it's normal to see them on the surface. Let's go to source and select volume. They're all inside, but what if the emitter mesh size was bigger? The particle meshes will penetrate the surface. Let's lower the number. What if we wanted to have a particle mesh about that size, and prevent them from extruding out from the parent mesh's surface? We can certainly make a good art just the way it is, like this. But is there a way to prevent that from happening? Let's use Eevee with Bloom. There are two ways to prevent this. One is to make instances of the particles real, and either scale or use a duplicated parent mesh. I'll add a glass material for the outer shell mesh. The idea is to make the particle instances real by using the modifier, and remove the original parent mesh. Let's put all the particle meshes into a new collection. This is one way to control the surface. I'm using a UV sphere as an example, but this method will come in handy for all other projects that require volume emitters. I'll show you another way after removing the first example's objects. The second example is by using a solidify modifier. Let's change the value for the thickness, and the shell mesh will expand. This is another way to control it, and the solidify modifier will work on any meshes that contains the volume emitter. I'll shrink the particle mesh's size and create a rotating and looping animation. Let's change some settings for the particles. On frame 1, I'll set a new keyframe on rotation, Z. On frame 250, I'll change the Z to 359 and set a new keyframe. In Animation tab, go to Channel, Extrapolation Mode, and select Linear Extrapolation Mode. There is our rotating animation. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.